वैष्णव जन तो तेने कही जे पीड़ पराई जाने रे।
यस, वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द फादर ऑफ नेशन महात्मा गांधी टुडे। वी आर गोइंग टू रिमेंबर हिम टुडे ऑन हिज बर्थडे 2nd October. Today is his 151st birthday. He was born on 2nd October 1869. Now let's try find out his lifestyle, about him and his ideology. My life is my message. The way he lived his life was the message given to others that how you can lead a life, how he made himself an ideal for many, for several, not only around him, not only in his own country, but all across the globe. While I was searching for some good artwork, I came across this. And this was depicted beautifully by a student where Gandhiji, along with his four main followings, which he used to teach to others and he used to follow: truth, peace, love and equality, along with the famous three monkeys, which never used to see something bad, never used to hear something bad, and never used to speak something bad. Here I am going to discuss about the background of Mahatma Gandhi. His full name was Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, and he is the father of the nation. People fondly call him Bapu or father. Mahatma Gandhi was born on 2nd October 1869 at Porbandar in Gujarat. His father was Karamchand Gandhi. His mother, Putli Bai, was a very religious person. He was married to Kasturba Gandhi at the age of 13. After passing matric examination, he went to England for higher studies. He was a lawyer. In South Africa, Gandhiji fought against racism. Gandhiji took part in freedom fight in India. He was a great freedom fighter. Gandhiji's main teachings are non-violence, truth, and love to all mankind. We'll be discussing the teachings of Mahatma Gandhi here. Live life to the fullest. He gave this ideology. Since we have got life once, we should live it to the fullest. Second, always speak truth. Third, let the change begin from you. First you should change, then only you can change the others. Believe in love. He believed in love. That is why he used non-violence to get freedom. Fifth is, think before you act. People don't think sometimes and they react to certain things. But we should think before we act. Live to learn. We should always learn. There is no age to learn anything. We should always try to learn new things. And we should be positive. We should always think of the positive side of the things, because he said that if you think good will happen to you. Learn to forgive. Hamesha sabko maaf karna seekhna chahiye. Be true to yourself, and you should speak truth to yourself. There is a short story which I remember when Gandhiji was giving exam and he wrote a wrong spelling, but he was not correcting it, even though the teacher said him to correct it. The class teacher, the teacher who was there, he asked Gandhiji to correct it and to cheat. But Gandhiji didn't cheat and he wrote the wrong spelling because he was true to himself. He never cheated himself. The last, the tenth is care for Mother Earth. And that is why he fought that fight, the freedom fight. And he is the greatest, he is among the greatest freedom fighters our country has. And the major two teachings which he gave was Ahimsa and Satyagraha. Non-violence and Satyagraha. Right? He led his life following these two teachings which he always followed himself and taught to others also. In a gentle way, you can shake the world. You can even shake the world even if you are gentle. Zaruri nahi ki har yudh ladne ke liye hathiyar uthana pade. You can shake the world by your gentle moves, as Mahatma Gandhi did. And yes, how can we forget his charkha? He used to spun his own cloth and used to wear it. He was involved in several movements, among which was Satyagraha, the non-cooperation which started in 1920, and the civil disobedience. And what was civil disobedience? That they used to refuse to obey the laws. They were not ready to obey the laws. Appeals to one's sense of justice, put issue on public agenda, draw attention to unjust laws. Disobedience must be open, public and non-violent. The main thing was non-violent. The public of India, that means the Indians, were following the civil disobedience and they were not following the rules, the laws which Britishers made. They disobeyed publicly but non-violently. And yes, the Salt March or the Dandi March, where he walked almost 385 kilometers, and it was on 12th March. It started on 12th March and they reached, or this march ended on 5th of April. Now, as I was talking about the civil disobedient movement, here were certain agendas for which he opted and chose the civil disobedience movement. First of all, he took this decision to support the army, to reduce the expenditure by 50%, for civil servants, to release the political prisoners, salt tax, protection to Indian industry, reduce land revenue by 50%. Here we are going to discuss about some of the achievements of Mahatma Gandhi. That Mahatma Gandhi stopped British rule in India and finally we got independence. He made life better for the poor people. As you all know, he removed or abolished the untouchability from India and he used to call the untouchables Harijans. So he tried to give a better life to the poor people. He encouraged production of local products like yarn and cloth. Like Britishers used to take the raw materials from our country and they used to process it and send it back to our country at a higher rate. So Gandhiji tried to protect the industries of India and he also convinced people, he also inspired people so that the people themselves spin the yarn and make the cloth by their own. He showed the world the power of non-violence. Yes, he was the person who showed the path of non-violence and he showed that by non-violence also many fights can be fought. And at last, he loved cleanliness. He used to clean his ashram, Sabarmati ashram, by his own. So this is why our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi, he launched Swachh Bharat Abhiyan on his birthday, on Mahatma Gandhi's birthday, on Gandhi Jayanti, and through this, we try to maintain cleanliness in our locality, in our surroundings, school, home, everywhere. So we should try to clean our house, our surrounding, our environment, our school, everywhere. We should try to maintain cleanliness. And it's like we are only getting benefited by cleanliness. Our cleanliness, this habit of keeping cleanliness will benefit us only. Because if we keep our society up, if we keep our house, if we keep our school neat and clean and tidy, then we get less chances to get diseased. Hame kam chances hota hai ki hame koi bimari lage, right? So we should try to maintain cleanliness. With this, I wish you all a very happy Gandhi Jayanti, and you all kindly accept or inherit or try to adopt at least one of the teachings of Gandhiji in your life. You'll be very successful, because even if you're not successful, you'll have that inner peace in your heart that you're not cheating anyone, that you're not telling a lie, that you're not cheating yourself, right? So that will give you inner happiness. So as Gandhiji is an ideal for many people across the globe, I personally should, as I also follow him in many aspects, so I would also recommend you also to kindly follow few of his aspects, which will definitely make your life wonderful. Thank you, children, and have a good day.